God. But Lord, let us come on one accord on this day, mighty God. Lord, we know a house divided, mighty God, will fall, mighty God. But Lord, we come together in unity on this day, mighty God. One mind, mighty God, in the name of Jesus, to fight the enemy like never before, God. In Jesus' name, have your way right now, mighty God. God, touch right now, mighty Lord. How many know it is a time we need to be together like never before? In Jesus' name, oh, glory be to you, mighty God. Have your way right now, mighty God.
Could've lost my mind. You've been better than good to me.
I should have been dead.
I should have been dead. You've been better than good to me.
Should have lost my mind.
Should have lost my mind. You've been better than good to me.
Cause you've been better than good to
me. You've been better than good to
me. You've been better than good to
me. You've been better than good. You've been better than good to me. 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 You've been better than good to me.
You've
been better than good to me.
You've been better than good to me. Should have lost my mind.
Should have lost my mind. You've been better than good to me.
Cause you've been better than good.
You've been better than good to me.
You've
been better than good to me.
You've
been better than good to me.
You've
been better than good to me.
You've
been better than good to me.
You've
been better than good to me.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, God. On my track, trying to turn me back, but I got joy.
Joy will
come on, come on. I've been in the storm and rain, I had heartaches and pain, but I got joy.
Joy will,
yeah, yeah, yeah. I've been up, I've been down, I've been leveled to the ground, but I got joy.
Joy will.
I've been wrong, but I'm still pressing on, because I got joy.
Joy will. Joy will.
Said it will come in.
Come in.
Come on in.
Come on in.
Say joy will.
Joy will.
Said it will come in.
Come in.
Come on in.
Come on in.
I had heartaches and pain, but I got joy.
Joy will.
I've been up, I've been down, I've been leveled to the ground, but I got joy.
Joy will.
I've been wintered, I've been wrong, but I'm still gonna press on, but I got joy.
Joy will.
Everybody say joy will.
Joy will.
Come
in.
Come on in.
Come on in.
Say joy will.
Joy will. Come in.
Come on in.
Come on in.
Although it's dark.
Although it's dark. Yeah. And you cannot see.
Yeah.
Just trust in him.
Just trust in him.
And just believe.
Cause we walk by faith.
We walk by faith.
And not by sight.
Now by side,
it's gonna be alright.
It's gonna be alright.
witness in here today. Joy will.
Joy will.
You don't have to cry no more, because you know that joy will.
Joy will.
Say joy will.
Joy will.
Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Come on, let's give God some praise in this place. Amen. God is worthy to be praised. Oh, glory be to God. God, we thank you. We thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank God for another day in the house of God. Amen. Thank God for our online church. Amen. Thank God for you all being in tune with us on this day. Amen. Thank God for another opportunity to worship God in your giving. Amen. How many excited about giving to God on this day? Amen. Is there anybody in the house can beat God giving? Oh, no, but that's what I'm talking about. I thought I was going to get somebody on that one right there. God is good, but how many know we cannot beat God giving no matter how much we try? Amen. Let's just start off a little bit, a little testimony. Amen. First thing is, we can't beat him because he woke us up this morning. Right. Amen. We got breath in our body. Amen. That might mean small and insignificant, but how many know during these times we're living in right now, amen, to be able to wake up in the morning, amen, we better give God some praise in this place. Amen. God is good, and he is worthy to be praised. Thank God for this opportunity to bless God in giving, because I tell you, this is the way you're going to get blessed. Amen. I'm familiar with the sowing of the seeds because I grew up. When I grew up, my grandmother, after you've heard me state before, amen, we just planted basically all the food that we needed, that we had to have. Amen. We planted it. So I seen when that one pea went into the ground, and then when it grew up, there was multiple peas on that stem there. Amen. So I seen the multiplication of that one seed there. Same as in the kingdom of God. That's what he explained to us in his word. Amen. So when you give, God's going to give back to you tremendously. Amen. A lot of times it's not always material or monetary wise. Amen. But sometimes you may just need a blessing in your spirit. Amen. You may need a word from God. Amen. You may need healing in your body. Amen. We never know how it's going to come. God is truly good, isn't he? Amen. And he's worthy to be praised. Amen. Also, too, want to remind everyone about this Saturday. Amen. We will be having our youth prayer night. Youth prayer night. Come on, get it up for our youth prayer night. Amen. How many know these is our future? Amen. Our youth is our future. We're going to have our youth prayer night on this upcoming Saturday night. And also, too, going on into Sunday morning, we will be celebrating 36 years. Amen. The Lighthouse of Inception of 36 years. Amen. Thank God for our Bishop Alvin Walker. Amen. And Mother Claire Walker. They started this church over 36 years ago. Amen. So thank God we'll be able to celebrate that. Amen. Bishop Kelvin Stewart will be coming in from Jonesboro, Louisiana. And we're going to have a time, you all. Amen. So I want you all to, that's out there, that's in tune. Amen. Be a part of it as well. Amen. But I want you to invite somebody out. Amen. Come celebrate this 36 years of a God moving in an awesome way. Amen. In the church. We on our way to heaven. And we enjoying the trip in Jesus' name. At this time, the brothers can come. Amen. For those who are giving today, amen. You may give so at this time in Jesus' name.
My God is awesome. My God is awesome. He can move mountains. Yes, he can. Keep me in the valley. My God is awesome. Yes, he is. Forever he will reign. My God.
My God is awesome.
He can move mountains.
He can move mountains.
Keep me in the valley.
Keep me in the valley.
Hide me from the rain.
Hide me from the rain.
My God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Heals me
when I'm broken. Strength where I've been weakened. Whenever he will reign.
My God is awesome.
My God is awesome. He can move mountains. Keep me in the valley.
Hide me from the rain.
From the rain.
My God is awesome.
My God is awesome. Heals me when I'm broken.
Strength
where I've been weak.
Somebody praise his holy name.
Wherever he will
God is awesome.
My God is awesome.
Today
I am forgiven.
His grace
is why I'm living.
Somebody ought to praise his holy name.
Praise his holy name.
My God.
My God is awesome.
Hey, awesome.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy. He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
Awesome.
Awesome.
Come on and help me celebrate. Awesome.
Awesome. Hey.
He's great.
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 Awesome.
Awesome.
Hey, awesome.
Awesome.
How many know he's awesome? How many know he is awesome? Amen. You got to get personal at this time. How many know God is awesome? I see some people that know that he is awesome. Oh, glory be to God. I see some people in this place don't mind giving God praise. You don't care who's beside you. Glory be to God. God, we worship your name, Jesus. Come on, let's worship him. Yes, he is. He's awesome.
Awesome. Awesome. My God is awesome.
Hey, awesome.
He's awesome.
God is awesome.
Awesome.
Hey,
he's awesome.
Hey,
he's mighty.
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 Awesome.
Glory. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I believe something broke in the spirit. Oh, glory. My. The praising and the ushered us on in into worship. Come on, let's worship him at this time. Worship him. Oh, glory. Come on, just worship him. Worship him. Somebody need a touch right now. Somebody don't need to wait to the end of service. Somebody need a touch right now. Oh, glory. 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 God, we worship your holy name, mighty God. Isn't he worthy to be praised? Oh, glory. Come on, just enjoy the presence of the Lord right now. Come on, just let him have his way right now. Let him touch you right now. Come on, don't stop. Reach out to God. Oh, glory. Oh, glory. Glory. God, you're worthy. You're worthy. You're worthy, Jesus. Come on, you're worthy. You're worthy. God, we thank you right now, mighty God. We praise your holy name, mighty God. We thank you when we feel right now, mighty God. We give you praise in this place, mighty God. Oh, glory be to your holy name, mighty God. Our power's in you, mighty God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory be to your holy name. Say, Marodokoma. Say, Kianede. Oh, glory be to you, God. Glory be to you, God. Glory be to you, mighty God. Glory be to you, God. We need you right now, mighty God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Glory be to your name. Say, just enjoying his presence. How many know in his presence is fullness of joy? Glory. Glory be to God. Just let him have his way in your life. Come on, you got to push all the clutter out your mind. Push it out your mind right now. Get your mind on Jesus. Get your mind on Jesus. Glory be to you, mighty God. We thank you, Jesus. Thank you so much, praise team. Amen. I don't know about you, but I can listen to them all day long. Thank God for our praise team. God, we thank God for the anointing that's upon their lives in Jesus' name. We're going to go before the Lord. Amen. We're going to believe God. Amen. For a word on this day in Jesus' name. First of all, I just want to thank God. Thank God for my leaders. Always going to give honor to them. Amen. Thank God for this opportunity just to be before you this day. Don't take it lightly. Amen. I just want to thank God for our bishop, Mother Walker. Thank God in their absence. Thank God for their labor of love, their sacrificial love for us. Amen. Thank God if it wasn't for them, amen, we wouldn't be here right where we're at right now in Jesus' name. So we thank God for God using them mightily, amen, throughout this time and even in these last days in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank God again for our online audience. We want to thank you, Lord. Thank you all for tuning in with us on the day. Amen. I want to thank God for my brothers and sisters that I'm looking at right now. Amen. Thank God for my brothers and sisters. I always just like to give honor to my brothers and sisters as well, because how many know we in this thing together? Amen. How many know we in war? Amen. And how many know we got to be together? I was listening to a gentleman who was a Green Beret. Amen. I don't know what team he was speaking to in this city, but he was speaking to somebody. Amen. And he was letting them know that, hey, when he go to war, he know he had some brothers that had his back. back. Amen. And I don't know about you, but when I go to war, I want to know somebody's was with me there. Amen. That we're hand to hand. And when we go into this war, amen, we're going to fight, amen, to death do us part. Amen. I don't know about you, but I'm here to fight with you. Amen. Not against you. Amen. But with you. Amen. I don't want no disagreements between me and my brother. Amen. I want to be with you there. How many know we need unity, amen, during these times in Jesus' name? We need unity like never before. We need to get all the isms and schisms out the way. Amen. And let's come together and worship God, amen, mightily in these times in Jesus' name. How many know we got it starts right here? Amen. It starts with me. It starts with me. Amen. I got to be the one. Get all the ism and schism out of me. Amen. To where I can walk along with my brothers and sisters. Amen. As we go into battle. Amen. And how many know we in a battle that's already won? Oh, glory be to God. It's already fixed. It's already fixed. God is truly good. He's worthy to be praised. Again, I want to thank God for my wife. Thank God for my beautiful wife. Thank God for my children. Amen. Thank God. Amen. At this time, we're going to get into the Word of God. If you could turn your Bibles to the book of 1 John, the 4th chapter. Book of 1 John, the 4th chapter. And we're going to get into the Word in Jesus' name. How many are going to pray with me today? Amen. How many are going to preach with me today? According to what I say, huh? Glory be to God. God is good. Amen. St. John, the first chapter. I mean, 1 John, the 4th chapter, starting at the 7th verse. It says, "Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. In this was manifested the love of God toward us, because that God sent his only begotten Son into the world, that we might live through him." 10th verse, "Herein love is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins." 11th verse, "Beloved, if God loved us, we ought also to love one another." Amen. "No man have seen God at any time. If we love one another, God dwelleth in us, and his love is perfected in us." Glory be to God. Thank God for the word. Amen. Let us go before the Lord in prayer. The Heavenly Father, we thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you, Lord, for our leaders in the absence. We ask you, Lord, to continue healing our bodies, God. And God, we ask you, Lord, to move in this service this day. God, we can do nothing without you, Jesus. God, I pray that I decrease and that you increase, God. Speak on this day, God, the word that you have for your people. This day is ordained by you, God. God, I pray, Lord, don't let it be a word of flesh, but it be a word of spirit, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. The topic we're going to talk on today, the power of God's love. The power of God's love. Amen. We have to admit, and this probably will be a part of my introduction in most of my sermons, because it's what we're dealing with right now. And how many know we want to be real? We want to be real on what's happening in our society right now. Amen. Where are we going? What's happening? And what's taking place? And how many know we're living in a time, we're talking about the power of God's love. How many know we need the love of God shared abroad in this place, in this world, like never before? We're living in a time where man's conscience is seared, amen, to where they don't care, amen, about you, amen. They don't care if they shoot you. Amen. They don't care. Amen. My grandma used to say they'll shoot you just to see you jump and fall. She used to have a statement. She would say that. But I'm here to share with you that, that's not to take lightly, because we're going to bind that devil. The devil's a liar. He can't have our young men. He can't have our young women. Because you know what happens when that takes place? You got two people that dies. You got the person who literally dies, then you got the person who's going to be dying for his life is concerned, because they're going to be behind bars most of their life, ruining their life. So we live in a time where they don't care. They don't care about life. They don't care if they go to jail. They don't care if they die. Amen. So really and truthfully, we're in a time where we need to express love like never before. This world needs to see somebody expressing the love of God. Amen. They need to see the power of God's love during this time. Amen. And the only way they're going to be able to see it is through the life of the believers. Amen. Through the ones who are living, amen, this life, the ones who are striving to live for God. That's how the world is going to see. First John is the great book of love, is that what they call it? And love is mentioned 46 times in 135 verses in 1 John. John is an elder statement in the church, wrote the letters to his dear children. Amen. It's said that he called them dear children simply because he was probably the elder. Amen. And they were young. Amen. Others was young. And he's probably the oldest apostle and maybe possibly only apostle living during this time. Amen. But one thing about it, John, it goes on to say in this book, he presented God as the light, as love, and as life. John presents God as love, giving, dying, forgiving, and blessing. Amen. At the same time, he also, in this book, he worked on false doctrine. He worked on heresy. He worked on especially this religion that popped up during his time called Gnosticism. Gnostic. It was a second century religion movement claiming that salvation could be gained through a special form of secret knowledge, amen, that they were receiving. Amen. So it was false. Amen. I'm here to share with you today, just as John, amen, spoke to the church, he's speaking to us today. We have to, in this same time today, we have to watch out, because there's all kind of religions that's popping up, all kind of error that's going on in our society. People saying that I'm the Christ and so on. These are things that we're going to be experiencing during our time. Amen. And the time that our children will be here. So we have to be careful, and we have to understand that we have to combat, amen, these same type religions that's trying to pop up, or spirit of error, amen, that's popping up in our society during this time. That's why we must know the word of God for ourselves. We got to know the word of God. We must understand, get an understanding of the word of God. We must eat, chew, and live this word like never before. Amen. Because the enemy is trying his best, amen, to make the church a disarray. He wants the church to be against the church. He wants these churches fighting against that church. He wants that church fighting against this church. Amen. But how many know we got to come together during these times? Amen. But how can two walk together unless they agree? Amen. We must be agreeable, amen, according to the word of God. Amen. It can't be a religion that pops up and say, well, I believe it this way. Amen. Just like it did in the time of John. Amen. God wants us, amen, to know the word of God. He wants to know the truth. Amen. He wants to know that Jesus' name baptism is the truth. Amen. He wants to know that receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost is the truth, with the evidence of speaking in tongues. That still happens today. That experience still goes on today. Amen. It's none of the past. Amen. But it's for us. It's for our children. And it's for those who are fall in Jesus' name. Oh, glory be to God. God is truly good. I want to get ahead of myself. This love is described as it is unconquerable. Amen. Meaning it's incapable of being conquered. Amen. The love, this power is so powerful. God's love is so powerful. It's incomparable. Amen. Nothing can conquer it. Let's look in Romans, the 8th chapter and 37th verse. I'm sure you're familiar with these passages of scriptures. It says in 37th verse, it says, nay, in all these things we are more than what? Conquerors through him that love us. Amen. Do we have any conquerors in this place? Amen. It said that we are more than a conqueror. Amen. We're not just a conqueror, we're more than a conqueror. It's some things in your life right now that you need to conquer. I'm here to share with you, you can conquer it through Christ. Amen. I'm here to share with you, there's some people that are dealing with some things right now in their life as I speak. Amen. And God, he want to let you know that you are more than a conqueror. Amen. That you can conquer those things that's going on in your life. You can conquer the things that's coming against you right now. Amen. Somebody's dealing with somebody, amen, that the enemy is coming against you hard right now. I don't know about you, but the enemy is trying his best to turn me back. I'm used to it though, because the last 30 years that's what he's been trying to do all along. Amen. But God lets me know in his word that I am more than a conqueror. Amen. That I'm ready for the battle, Satan. Amen. I'm ready, devil. I'm gonna stand up, amen, and let you know that I'm ready to fight you to the end in Jesus' name. Amen. I don't know about you, but I'm a fighter in Jesus' name. I'm all about fighting, man. I'm telling you, I grew up, amen. I'm being honest with you. Back in the day, I would fight, amen. But I'm fighting now for my Jesus in Jesus' name. Amen. I grew up, amen, when I played on that football field, amen, when I went on that field, I went for war. Amen. I wasn't taking no names for nobody. Amen. I come to play, amen, and I'm here in this war right here. I mean, this is the most important war that we can be in. Amen. And that is the war between the enemy. Amen. I don't know about you, but I got the war because I don't want the enemy to take my children. Amen. I got the war because I got grandchildren now. Amen. I got the war because I got brothers. I got some people that I want to see saved. I don't know about you. We got the war. I'm more than a conqueror. Amen. I believe we got some people that's more than a conqueror in this place. Amen. 38 verse, it says, I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor heights, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. I don't know about you, but I'm not letting nothing separate me from his love. Amen. I may have some hiccups and some fall downs or whatever, but I'm going to get back up in this war in Jesus' name. Amen. How many know we're going to go through some stuff sometimes? How many know we're going to fall on our face sometimes? Amen. Let me tell you something. The enemy, let me tell you, not just the enemy, this flesh. Sometimes this flesh, amen, get weak. Amen. How many know that's why we got the war against the flesh in Jesus' name. Oh, glory be to God. The battle's not just against that devil. Amen. It's against that flesh as well. Amen. It's about us. Amen. How many know this thing is wicked right here? The Bible lets us know this thing is wicked. Nobody don't want to talk about that, but let me tell you something. We got to talk about that thing, because next thing we know, we'll be doing something we ain't got no business doing. Amen. And I'm here to share with you. That's why we got to keep this thing under subjection in Jesus' name. Oh, glory be to God. We talking about the power of God's love. The power of his love. Oh, glory be to God. God is a good God, and he is worthy to be praised. As y'all know, that's my saying there. He is a good God. He's a good God for me. Amen. I don't know about you, but I thank God for what he done in my life. I thank God for what he's doing. Let me tell you something. The enemy don't like Pastor Chris Houston. Amen. I believe somebody else need to put their name on it right there as well. Amen. He don't like me. Amen. Matter of fact, he hates me, amen, because of what I have down within me, and that is the Spirit of God, and he's trying everything he can, amen, to make me feel like I'm nobody, but I'm here to share I'm somebody in Christ, and I'm here to speak into your life that you are somebody. Don't let the devil make you feel like you're nobody, amen. The devil is a liar. Oh, glory be to God. Somebody been battling some low self-esteem. I'm here to share with you, just believe the word of God. Amen. We ran across a young lady yesterday. She had an issue with, amen, her appearance. Amen. She had an issue with, amen, how it got us to a point that she got down and out. Amen. But glory be to God. Thank God for my wife had a word for her. Amen. I'm here to share. Let me tell you something. The enemy will do his best during these times. Amen. He will utilize social media. Amen. He will utilize all kind of things. Amen. To compare ourselves with others and so on. How many know that's not even the Bible? The Bible lets us know. Amen. Don't compare yourself with others. Amen. I ain't got to look like you, and you ain't got to look like me. Amen. Oh, glory be. I don't know what it's coming from, but I believe somebody needs to hear this in this place. Amen. Somebody's so caught up on how I'm looking. Amen. How I'm doing this and how I'm doing that. Amen. God ain't looking at that. Amen. What God is looking at is what's in your heart. Amen. He's looking at how much love that you have shed abroad in your heart by the Holy Ghost. Oh, glory be to God. God is truly good. Now, I believe God wants us to look nice or whatever. I believe because why he done bless us with the things that we do have. But when we let it come to the point to where it's bothering us, amen, where it's getting us down and out, amen, to where I can't go no places because I don't look this certain way, I done gained this weight right here, and I lost too much weight right here, the devil is a liar. Oh, glory be to God. God loves each and every one of us. If you don't get nothing else today, I want you to point to yourself and say, God loves me. God loves me. He loves me. Oh, glory be to God. And you need to tell the devil, devil, you're a liar. I am special in the eyesight of God. Amen. Amen. You are special in the eyesight of the Lord. Amen. Another thing is this, his love is unending. It's unending, meaning it is eternal. Amen. Meaning it lasts forever. Jeremiah 31:3 says, the Lord has appeared of old unto me, saying, yeah, I have loved thee with an everlasting love. Everlasting love. Meaning it is for everlasting. Amen. His love. Therefore, with loving kindness have I drawn thee. Amen. God's love is eternal. Amen. It's eternal. Amen. He's not going to forget about you. Amen. His love is there. Even when we're in our mess, he's there. Amen. Even when we're down and out, he's there. Even when the anxiety, the depression that you're experiencing is there, he's there. Amen. His love is still there to let you know that I'm here with you. I want to bring you out of these situations that you're in right now. In Jesus' name, glory be to God. God is truly good. As I mentioned earlier, amen, the things that we see in our society, amen, the things that's taking place, amen, is the Bible fulfilling, as we know, amen. But one thing about it is the church of believers, amen, we are the light that's up on the hill, amen. The people see us, amen. They're going to see that these people of God are different. That's why it's so important that when we go on our jobs, amen, that we live the life the best we can, amen. Being led by the Spirit of God, amen, that we do the best we can to live a Christian life. Amen. When we go in our business, we should do it with a spirit of excellence. Amen. To let the people know, amen, that, hey, that I have the Spirit of God within me. It's the love of God that I have within me. Everywhere we go, we are being watched. Amen. And then, amen, they're going to ask, what church you go to? I go to the Lighthouse. Amen. They're going to ask, what church you go to? I go to the Lighthouse. Amen. How many know? Then they're going to start watching this church. I mean, they already watching us. Amen. They already know. Amen. Thank God for a great report. I believe we have a great report in this city in Jesus' name. And how many know we got to continue, amen, living for God, being that beacon of light for people, amen, who are looking, amen, to come to Christ in Jesus' name. How many know nobody's perfect? We're going to fall sometimes. But should we stay there? Oh, no. No, we got to get up. We got to get up out that sin and muck and mire. We got to get up out of that. Amen. And one key thing is this. We got to work on the thing. The key thing is not get up out of it and say, well, I might try that again. Or I may try that again. Or I'm allowing that trying it again. That's not true repentance. Amen. But when you truly repent, when you ask God for forgiveness, and Lord, you say, help me, God. Help me overcome this thing that's the thorn in my flesh right here. Help me overcome this right here in Jesus' name. Amen. But we have a church now. We have a church now that tries to feed off God's grace. Amen. And try to take it for granted. But I'm here to share with you. Amen. God has love. But one thing about it, he's also too, amen, he's a punisher. Amen. And his punishment has to come. There are consequences, amen, that come with sin. Amen. But there's a church that's rising up now. Amen. That feels like they can do this and they can do this and they can do that. Amen. How many know the church of the living God? The church of the living God. The church of the living God. Amen. Can't look to that church and say, well, I think we should compromise as well. We should go over here and be with this church, do like they do as well. No, the devil is a liar. Amen. That church is not gaining, amen, what God, amen, want us to do. This church, amen, is standing up for righteousness, holiness in Jesus' name. Oh, glory be to God. Can I just let God have his way? Amen. I'm just getting away from my notes and everything. I'm trying to get back to it. But hey, I just have to let God have his way in Jesus' name. I ask the Lord that the word be of spirit and not of this flesh. Amen. In Jesus' name. Glory be to God. How many know his love is unselfish? We know that. Amen. Just want to give you a definition of agape love. Agape love is selfless, sacrificial, unconditional love. Agape love is a term that defines God's immeasurable, incompatible love for humankind. Amen. This love is the highest of all the four loves. Amen. Agape love. His love is unconditional. It's unselfish. It asks for nothing in return. However, it leads man to repentance. Amen. And turn to God in love. Amen. Glory be to God. I'm so happy that God's love, amen, one day, amen, it reached way down. Amen. In those nightclubs. Amen. It reached way down. Amen. In that gross sin. Amen. It reached way down. Amen. In a time when I felt like, amen, I was nothing. I felt like committing suicide. Amen. I felt like doing all this crazy stuff. It reached way down. Amen. And began to let me know, say, I love you, son. I love you. Amen. Despite what I was doing, he loved me. He desired for me to live for him in Jesus' name. Oh, glory be to God. I believe we got some witnesses in here as well. Amen. That they are grateful. Amen. That God reached way down. Amen. And pulled you up, amen, out of this world of sin. Oh, glory be to God. Amen. Don't look in here and look at me, amen, like you've been a saint with a halo on your mind, on your head all your life. The devil is a liar. Amen. I can talk about what I've done because I know my God is the one that delivered me, amen, from the world of sin in Jesus' name. Oh, glory be to God. That's one thing the enemy tries to do. He tries to make people, amen, he tries to make people feel sad and down and out, amen, from the thing that if you've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Amen. You need to stand up and let the devil know, God, devil, you are a liar. I am set free, amen, by my God in Jesus' name. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Somebody gonna get a word in this place this day. God, have your way in this place. Have your way, Jesus. God is worthy to be praised. That's the problem we have. People, amen, judging and looking at each other. Amen, condemning everyone. Amen, putting them down. Amen, people don't want to come to a church like that. Amen. I mean, no, we need it. We can share with them. It's wisdom that you must have. Must have some wisdom. Some wisdom on how we deal with people when they are in their sin. Amen. Now, I'll be honest with you. I was so grateful that somebody told me, amen, that, hey, that you was not right in the eyesight of God. You are not right. Amen. I heard that word, gun barrel straight. Amen. Oh, glory be to God. Because it was that time that I seen the love of God. It was speaking through that word, amen, getting a hold of my heart. It was pulling me, amen, from that world of sin. It was cutting off, amen, all that stuff that I was desiring to do, that this flesh was desiring to do. Amen. We began to cut it off in Jesus' name. Amen. It began to let me know, you need to repent, Chris. Amen. You need to repent, amen, of this sin that you're doing. Amen. You need to come out of that. Come out that adulterous situation. Come out that fornication and adultery in Jesus' name. Oh, glory be to God. Oh, I named a sin there. Maybe I should have done that. I don't know. God is a good God. Amen. I don't know about you, but I'm a preacher that's going to name some sins sometime. Amen. All this lying going on, amen, in our society. People lie to you in a heartbeat. Amen. I'm here to tell you, God is a good God. Amen. How many know he's looking for a righteous church in Jesus' name? Come on, let's go on. Amen. His love is unmerited. Cannot be earned or deserved. It cannot be earned or deserved. His love is based on his grace. Amen. His grace. Amen. How many know grace is what saves us? But we can't take it for granted. Amen. We can't take it for granted. A lot of people are like, yeah, we can just float on through this thing. Amen. And oh, I can talk this way. I can do this way. Let me tell you something. Even the way we talk, amen. Even the way we talk, you got to understand that God, even like jesting, all this just talking out of term and stuff, amen. How many know a lot of times we just get to talking and talking and talking and talking. Next thing we lying and lying and lying, amen. Next thing we know, we saying something we ain't got no business saying, amen. That's the way the world do things, amen. How many know the Bible said keep our conversation what? Holy, amen. Do we look at those scriptures anymore? Amen. It said keep our conversation holy. Holy. Amen. Oh, glory be to God. I don't even know where that come from. It came from the Holy Ghost. Amen. It's unconditional. It's unconditional. It is not based on what we can or can not produce. Amen. It's not. It comes from the heart of God. Man can never reach a place when he is not loved by God. God loves us first. Amen. He loves us anyway, and he loves us eternally. Amen. It doesn't matter how bad you get. It's one thing about our God. He still loves us. Ain't he a good God? The individuals is out here doing all this crazy stuff. We got to bring it home. The stuff that we do sometimes crazy. He loves us. The power of God's love. He can love us, amen, even when we're in sin. Ain't he a good God? He loving us because he wants us to come out of that. I don't know about you. Living for God is not a burden to me. It shouldn't be a burden. Oh, that I got to obey all those rules and regulations. That's what people say now. The devil's a liar. I mean, know we just got to believe the word of God. I don't have to. I don't have to worry about the rules and regulations. I want to be right in the eyesight of God. Amen. And if the Lord is speaking to me, and I'm growing in him, amen, if I see that this is coming off me because I heard it in the word of God, man, I'm grateful. I am grateful for God's love. That's the power of his love. I don't want to go before the Lord and look him in the eye, and he say, depart from me. I know you not, worker of iniquity. Depart. My. I don't want that to happen. I want him to say, well done, my good and faithful servant. Amen. Enter in. Amen. How many want that? Amen. How many want to say, well done, my good and faithful servant? Oh, glory be to God. Not depart. I know you not. I don't want that. Well done, my good and faithful servant. Oh, glory be to God. And I believe we got some people in this place. Amen. We're on our way to heaven. And what we're doing, we enjoying the trip. We enjoying that trip. Amen. We fighting devils, kicking them to the side. Amen. We not going to let him know he not going to have our home. Amen. He not going to have me. No. We're on our way to heaven. And we enjoying that trip. In Jesus' name. Amen. That's our slogan around here. Thank God for our bishop. Amen. Glory be to God. His love. Amen. The love was demonstrated at Calvary. How many know that? God's love can best be seen at the cross. 2 Corinthians 5th chapter, 21st verse, it says, "For he have made him to be sin for us, that we might be made righteous, the righteous of God him in him." How many know he took our place? Jesus took our place. That's another thing. I don't want to never forget about the cross. Never. That's what this thing is about. It's about he going on that cross. He dying that we might be saved. His blood was shed that it would wash away our sins one day, over 2,000 some years after that. And he's still doing it today. Amen. I do not want to forget what happened on Calvary. I want to keep that before me. Amen. I want to cherish it. I want to honor it. I want it to always make me feel that, hey, that I owe him. I owe God. Amen. He don't owe me anything. Amen. But I owe him my life. Amen. I owe him. I need to be, amen, to the point to where, and we're living in a time where people feel like you owe them everything. We owe them everything. When they work on the job, they're not doing this for me. They're not doing this for me. Man, good Lord. Let me get myself out this kitchen. Oh, glory. Glory be to God. But how many know I knew at the time we go on a job, we didn't take it for granted. The Lord has blessed me with this job. And I'm going to do the best that I can. I don't go there seeing what, hey, I can get out of. And then when I get out of it, amen. And then they looking at me by doing something. And then they say, well, you ain't paying me enough for that. That's what we're living in. Time we're living in. But how many know the children of God that has the power of God's love residing in them? Amen. We show the world that when we go places, that we are going to do it as unto the Lord. I'm not doing it as unto man. When I do it as unto the Lord, it pleases man. I do it as unto God in Jesus' name. Amen. He saved us from hell. It is his death on the cross, the death that released his precious blood, that opened the door for salvation for every sinner. Amen. It opened the door for us. Is anybody excited about that? Can somebody give God some praise? I know it's kind of quiet in here right now, but can somebody just give God some praise for the blood of Jesus? For the blood, I don't know about you, this place should have erupted during this time because you're excited about the blood of Jesus. Your action shows. Oh, glory be to God. My. I'm excited about the blood of Jesus. Glory be to God. My. God is truly good. God is truly good. Say, Kamarodo ko siki anide. Oh, glory. If it wasn't for the blood, my. If it wasn't for the blood, where would we be? The blood. The blood that even today he cleansed me when I'm wrong. The blood. You know what hurts so? It's when people take for granted the blood. Take for granted. It's not a time to take for granted the blood. He died that we might be saved. We can't forget it. We can't forget it. May si kama se maroro koma. Hey. Oh God. Colossians 1 and 14 says, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sin. My. It's going to be the blood that's going to wash the sin away from this nation. It's going to be the blood. It's going to be the blood. Yes, God is calling this world, amen, to turn from their wicked ways. Turn. The blood is there. The blood's been shed. It's there. Sikama. Oh, glory. Thank God for the blood. Come on, let's just worship him. Give God some praise. Come on, give God some praise. We can't forget about the blood. We can't forget about it. Oh, glory. I don't know if it don't make you emotional, if it don't do something down inside you, something's wrong. Because it was the blood that gives us the opportunity, gives us a chance to be able to make it, to be able to see Jesus one day. Oh, glory. It was the blood. It's the blood. Glory be to God. Say marulu koma. I'm trying to go on, y'all. But look like God wants to do something right here. He wants to do something special right here. I mean, we got to teach it to our children. Amen. There was the blood. It's the blood. That's going to save their soul. That's going to deliver them from a world of sin. When we are born into this world, we are born into sin. You must be born again. Again, after being born of the natural birth. You must be born again of the spiritual birth. Glory be to God. My. Nothing but the blood. Nothing. Mama, I don't know how I'm going to go on from here. Glory to your name, Jesus. Nothing but the blood. Nothing but his blood. Mama. Say, Kororokoma. How many know we're going to make it? We're going to get through this. Church is rising up. It's taking its wings. Standing strong. Let me tell you something. The enemy, amen, he think he's going to take out the lighthouse. The devil is a liar. This church is going strong. It's going forth. It's going to grow in Jesus' name. Yeah, you got naysayers. You got some to say, oh, no, they ain't going to do nothing over there. But the devil is a liar. Keep on watching. Keep on watching. It's already doing it. God has been blessing us ever since we've been back. God has been blessing us. We're in revival right now. Oh, glory be to God. God is doing a great work right here at the Lighthouse Church. Through his people. Amen. Just want to share just a little bit more, and then we're going to have our altar call in Jesus' name. Yes, God. Notice throughout the Bible, there have been men who demonstrated God's love. Forgiving love was demonstrated by Joseph. He was lied about, sold as a slave, ripped from his home and father, falsely accused, put in prison, waiting, All because of his jealous brothers. My. Yet he forgave. He still was able to bless his brothers, his father them, in Jesus' name. There's another example of redeeming love. Hosea, his wife named Gomer, a prostitute, yet what redeeming love. Amen. She was redeemed. Compassionate love. We talk about Peter here. Peter denied Jesus three times before the cock crowed. Three times. He lied about him. Yet Jesus said this about him. On this rock, I will build my church. Oh, glory be to God. You can't beat his compassionate love. Let me tell you something. There's been some people that might have pointed their finger at you. Amen. Because some things that you've done in your life. But God is saying, hey, that through the compassionate love, amen, I'm forgiving you of your sin in Jesus' name. Amen. He could have destroyed Peter, but he built the church upon his ministry. Oh, glory be to God. Let you know you can't count people out. You can't count people out. You can't count them out. Oh, glory be to God. Because if they keep believing God, the purpose is down within them. You can't stop it. Amen. The devil can't stop it neither. So I'm here to share with you. Amen. The devil, if you try to think you're going to stop the purpose that God has in my life, amen, I'm here to share and look in your eye and let you know that you a lie and the devil a lie too. In Jesus' name. Somebody need to rise up and say, I got purpose. Amen. And nothing's going to stop it in Jesus' name. Nothing is going to stop it. Oh, glory be to God. Peter had purpose. Amen. He had purpose. My. Glory be to God. And last but not least, but healing love. Amen. I got to speak of me. Amen. Amen. It was me that was full of pride, full of anger, bitter, jealous, burning with lust. Amen. But my God reached down and picked me up out of miry clay. Amen. How many know you got to get personal sometime? I'm so grateful that he did that. Oh, glory be to God. Going back, thank the Lord for the blood. Thank God for his blood in Jesus' name. God is truly good. And he's worthy to be praised. Who wouldn't serve a God like that? Who wouldn't serve? Yeah, you can play, Sam. Who wouldn't serve a God like that? Yes, God. There's some people. Maybe not even through somebody stating it, but just through certain situations that you've been through over time and time and time. And you feel like you're not getting anywhere. But God wants to let you know, you're my Peter. Just keep waiting. You're my Joseph. Just keep waiting. I got purpose for your life. God's going to use you during this time. He's going to reveal to you your purpose. Some he already have. You know your purpose. But there are some that are struggling. Which way to go? What should I do? God's going to reveal it to you in Jesus' name. I decree and declare right now in Jesus' name. Glory be to God. Amen. At this time, could we all stand? We're going to stand at this time. And we're going to go before the Lord. I mean, no. Nothing but the blood. Let's get it on our mind again. Nothing but the blood. My. love for the Savior. It says, if you love me, keep my commandments. How many know we got to love, have a love for the scriptures? We got to read this word. We got to study it. Psalms 119 and 140 says, thy word is very pure. Therefore, thy servant loveth it. 127 verse of the same chapter says, therefore, I love thy commandments above gold. Yeah, above fine gold. And how many know we got to love the sanctuary? This sanctuary. We can't forget about the place. This place. Bible says, not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together, as a manner of some is, by exalting one another, and so much the more as ye see the day approaching. My, the day is approaching. And we got people that want to leave. But how many know we gotta enter the sanctuary? Not just the sanctuary here physically, but we gotta have a sanctuary of our own. Of our own, to where we can go before God. Amen. And last but not least, the love for the saints. We got to love people. We got to love our brothers and sisters in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm going to love you whether you love me or not. In Jesus' name. I may be a little different, but hey, I'm going to still love you. Glory be to God. God is a good God. Let us go before the Lord. At this time, those that you may have some on your heart that you want to pray about today, or you may want salvation, you may want to see Jesus one day, I want you to come. Amen. I want you to come at this time. This concludes us. Thank God for our online service. We thank God for you all in Jesus' name. Amen. There may be someone that just want a touch from God. You just want a touch from him today. Then there's some things I may not be able to name, but you know what it is. Come at this time. We serve a God who's a healer. You may need healing in your body. We serve a God who's a healer. He's a deliverer. He wants to hear you. Amen. And sometimes an act of faith, reaching out, just by simply walking down those aisles, gets God's attention, gets his attention. And sometimes it just might not be nothing. You just want to give God praise. You want to come to these altars. You want to pray with somebody else. You want to pray for them. Amen. Come at this time. In Jesus' name. Come at this time. I'm believing God's going to touch somebody in this place this day. He has a word for somebody. He has a special touch for somebody. Glory. So at this time, just come. Come down. Come. Don't worry about people. Just between you and the Lord. Isn't he good? He's good. Yes. Yes,
ma'am. I lift my hand.
Total adoration to you.
You reign on the throne. For you are God
and God alone.
It's because of you
my cloudy days are gone.
I can sing to you
this song.
I just want to say
that I love you more than
lift my hands in total adoration to you.
You reign upon the throne. For you are God.
For you are God and God alone.
It's because
of you my cloudy days are gone.
I can sing to you
this song.
I just wanna say
that I love you more than anything.
And I adore.
I worship and adore.
Just wanna tell you that I love you.
That I love you
so much more
than anything.
Hey, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and I adore.
I worship and
Just wanna tell you I love you.
That I love you more than anything.
Hey, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and I adore you.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and I adore.